Blue Ruin was directed by Jeremy Saulnier and debuted at the 2013 Cannes Film Festival to critical acclaim. The film had quite the interesting pre-production in that both producer Macon Blair and Jeremy Saulnier had spent years trying to make movies together, but after 2007's critical and box office failure, Murder Party, they figured this would be their last go of it. They started a Kickstarter for the movie, generating a modest $35,000, which ended up allowing other producers to kind of catch on, pushing the budget up to about $400,000. And it's a good thing they did, because after the positive Cannes reception of the film, it did a small North American run and generated $930,000, double the film's budget. Both the director and the producer would go on to direct later films. Macon would go on to direct I Don't Want to Be on This Earth Anymore for Netflix, and Saulnier would go on to direct Green Room, which I didn't know until after I saw this film that he was the director of. It's a great movie. Patrick Stewart in the lead. And then he also directed Hold the Dark for Netflix, which is an original I still need to check out. It's definitely on my watch list, though. The movie itself is fantastic. Macon Blair plays a equally parts tragic and hard-to-read character named Dwight, who starts off the movie homeless on the beach, spending years suffering through the turmoil of someone having murdered his parents. And it is the beginning of the film that we see that that man has been let out of jail, and Dwight must travel from Delaware all the way back home to the Virginia and Kentucky areas to start his revenge journey. It is a little different than your typical revenge thriller, though, because Dwight is not a badass. He is not Liam Neeson from Taken. He's not Keanu Reeves from John Wick. He is not skilled in this field. No combat training or anything like that. He spends a lot of the movie having flukes, dropping the keys to his own car, driving the car with the popped tire, getting disarmed in combat. And while that may sound like it might be bordering on satire of the whole genre, it's actually just used to just add to the bone-grating intensity that the film puts you in the entire time. Like, even from the opening shot where he's bathing in some rich person's house and they show up at the house as he's in there squatting and he jumps out the back door and runs through the town naked, that's not quite comical. It's very suspenseful and it really set the mood for the movie, weirdly enough, and just that it wasn't going to be letting up for the hour and a half that you were there. The film also feels way more expensive than $400,000. The soundtrack swells and blends beautifully with the ambiance of the film. The beautiful panoramic shots of the nature as he travels from state to state, whether it's the back roads during a blue evening or the bright green field at his redneck buddy's farm when he's getting gun instructions, which is also probably the only actual comical film in the whole movie before it just all descends into madness. There is a big twist at the end of the film that kind of explains why all of this is going on to the extent that it is, but I'm not going to reveal that here. You should definitely give it a watch. I'm going to give the movie a 9.5 out of 10. It's a fantastic film. It's beautifully shot, beautifully acted, outstanding soundtrack, and all in all, solid watch. Definitely give it a shout out, and we're going to be doing a couple more videos on Netflix things that are kind of hidden from you in the algorithm, so definitely be checking back every week or week or so, depending on the production of all this. But yeah, like, comment, subscribe, and we'll see you next time.